Now, what would you do if I told you you could save the world by drinking beer? It sounds crazy, but it's true. Take a listen.
Our world is in peril. War and pollution caused by oil and greed has pushed our planet to the brink. But there is hope. Brewtroleum, biofuel made from beer, formulated from the yeast and grain left over after we finish brewing DB Export. Men, the world needs you to drink DB Export. For peace, prosperity, for the polar bears. The future is in your hands.
Hey, where are you going?
To save the world.
Well, what time are you going to be back?
About 9. Text if I'm going to be late.
Drink DB Export. Save the entire world.
How great is that ad? But it is true. New Zealand company DB Export have developed, this is what it's called, brewtroleum, a new petrol that is literally made from beer. And to tell us more, we're joined this morning by Sean O'Donnell from DB Export. Hi, Sean. Congratulations. Is this every man's true dream?
Yeah, I think it is. I think when we were sitting down having a few beers and coming up with some ideas, and to think that we could turn natural beer waste into biofuel, yeah, that's every man's dream. Drink a beer and save the world's a great dream.
Absolutely wishful thinking, I think. How does it work?
Well, it's a pretty simple process. We, in the brewing process, we make a lot of yeast slurry, and that's a natural beer waste. And then effectively we take that and distill that natural beer waste down into ethanol, and then that ethanol's mixed with normal petroleum, and we add about 10% biofuel to 90% petrol, and it makes a really high-grade premium biofuel. So works well in most cars. So, yeah, it sounds simple. It's complicated getting there, but we've managed to do it, and we're pretty proud of it.
Yeah, here in Australia, we used to have a car that ran on beer as well. It was called a Kingswood. But in all seriousness, though, beer and cars are things that don't normally go together or not supposed to. Where did this idea actually come from?
Well, I think it came... Our beer brand DB Export's been around for about 80 years, and our founder, Morten Coutts, was an ideas man, and he created a whole number of different ideas, and that's shown through some of the product we've created over the many years. And so we thought that we needed to do more around bringing great ideas to life and showing, you know, New Zealanders that we can still do great things. And sustainability is a big part of New Zealand lifestyle, and so when we were sitting down having a few beers, we thought, well, what else can we do with our beer, and one of the brewers said, well, we've got this natural beer waste, and I've heard we can make it into a biofuel. So we were like, let's have a crack, and that's how it began.
Sean, brewtroleum is obviously better for the environment, but how does it compare to other fuels? Does it last as long? Is it more expensive?
It's the same price. So I think the key difference is it runs exactly like your normal petrol. The difference is you're getting about an 8% saving on carbon. So that for one car, that's about 250 kilograms of carbon you're saving a year. And I guess if you start adding that up, if you have 2 million cars on the road each year using this product, that's 500,000 tonnes of carbon you're saving from going into the environment. So it seems small, but when you put it out amongst the many cars on the road, not only in New Zealand but across the world, it becomes quite a big sustainability play.
Yeah.
And it's a new revenue model for the police. Now they can breathalyse the cars. Is it available worldwide or just in New Zealand?
Just in New Zealand at this stage. We're in a trial phase, so we've got a six-week trial just to see how consumers embrace it. We've had a lot of questions around biofuels and, you know... Like many males, I have pride in my car and I want to make sure I'm putting the right things into it. So I've had a lot of questions around biofuel and if it's good for the vehicles. Well, it definitely is. There's only a few cars that can't run on a biofuel, and it's great for the environment. And I think the other great thing about this campaign is that guys don't have to change their behaviours. They can still go and have a beer that they love. All they have to do is... drink a DB Export and they're helping save the world.
Oh, saving the world.
I think a really exciting news too is we're about to launch our DB Export Citrus into Australia in late September. So from late September, Australians will be able to help us save the world as well by drinking DB Export. So we've started New Zealand, but
imagine how refreshed your car would be after that. Mm.
Now, Sean, this is amazing. Yes. It's pretty groundbreaking development and technology to find out we can actually run our cars on beer. Is there anything else that beer can actually be used for?
Getting drunk.
And drink it, apparently.
Well, it's obviously a great product for sociability. We are working all the time on other ideas. So brewtroleum is the first of what we hope will be many ideas that we can showcase beer in a different way. So we'll be continuing to work on brewtroleum over the next year. But following that, we've got a couple of projects that we're just starting to look at that hopefully will get to fruition for kind of this time next year. So it's quite exciting for us because we're taking a product that, you know, everyone knows so well and starting to change the game. And I think it's got people excited about beer again, and craft beer is doing that, but we also feel we can do that as well.
Sean, congratulations and thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Not a problem.
Have you ever heard of brewtroleum?
No, well, I think it's new. But it'd be interesting to see how you can, you can actually roll it out across the rest of the industry. Like, you have to make a lot of beer, I imagine, just to get the waste to put in your car. I'm not sure how efficient.
Only a brewery could come up with their ad department with that concept of saving the world. Only a brewery.
It's amazing.